contest is scheduled for one call. Introducing first, making his way to the ring from Tokyo, Japan, Wyvern!
Good evening, wrestling fans from the world-famous AWL Arena in Tokyo, Japan. This is the Animated Wrestling League, episode 287. And tonight, not only will the IWGP Heavyweight Championship be defended in the main event, we are starting a brand new tournament, the Faction戦争 Faction War in the Animated Wrestling League, an Atomicos tournament. This could get out of hand very quick. But we're starting off in one-on-one competition as Wyvern faces off against the forces of his former boss. Wyvern currently entering this match with a record of 44-29, ratio of plus 15. His opponent enters the match with a record of 73-68, a ratio of plus 5. So, more experience on the side of evil, but more success on the side of good.
His opponent, making his way to the ring from the laboratory, representing and accompanied by the Dorei Air 05.
And this is interesting, ladies and gentlemen. Dr. Jigoku present at a Dorei Corps match. He doesn't do that very often. But notice how the other two are sort of flanking M05. You got H03, DB02. What's left of the original five-member team? Unfortunately, LJ04 killed by the augments, and W01, Wyvern, found his freedom. He was able to break away thanks to the powers of the Star of Aztec and our reigning AWL Grand Champion, Aztec Kaiser Neo. Those control masks on the faces of these former AWL heroes, restricting their free will, making them slaves to Dr. Jigoku. And you hear it, all for Dr. Jigoku. Subete, Jigoku Hakase no Tame. Well, that's disheartening. Kick to the midsection, no collar, no elbow, tie up to start here. Face buster by Wyvern, that we have not seen in quite a few weeks, actually. Since his freedom, since his release from the Dorei Corps. I guess he's been taking some time to, wait a minute, small package out of nowhere. One, the foot's on the ropes. Two, referee didn't see the foot. One. There we go. One, two, reversal again. One, two, no. Wyvern in control. No. Finally, M05 able to kick out of that. Wyvern dominating a new aggression. His time away, helping him to get himself sorted out, I think. Step over Etsugiri by the young dragon. Only a minute in now, and it's been all Wyvern. Dragon drop! Dragon drop! Dragon drop! And he's setting up for Izzy Satsuwaza, the referee, getting involved here. DB02, wait a minute! Isatsuwaza! Shinjirai Sunrise! He knows the referee was out of position. And Wyvern just gonna continue the fight. Off of the ropes, big splash! Using every ounce of that body weight. This light heavyweight match, if we still had weight divisions in the AWL, I'm sure Wyvern would be a former light heavyweight champion. M05 Majiku, before his time under the control of Jigoku, the longest reigning light heavyweight champion of all time, longest reigning AWL champion of any division of all time. Going all straight to the top rope, Senton, straight out of Mexico City, the warrior of light, before he fell to the darkness. his very mask, his very soul stained by the evil of Dr. Jigoku. Crucifix, no, double, oh! Casting the spell of La Mystica, Jumon! No submission there, now looking, I think, for the endless light, that physics-defying finishing move, Hisatsuwaza, endless light! Or endless dark, perhaps, now. One, two, and Wyvern just kicked out of the endless light. I don't believe it. That match ended, that move ended dozens of matches for Wyvern over the years. Orb of Light, at least that's what it used to be called. And now twisting into the submission, the arm lock and the face wrench. Cranking on that neck, but Wyvern able to get out of that fairly easily. 7 minutes and change remaining, huge knee drop. As the man chosen by the original AWL champion, Dragon, to carry his sigil forward unto the next generation. About to show what he is capable of himself off of the top rope. And I think using, yes, is gonna go for the exact same combination Majiku did. A little bit of mind games here, ladies and gentlemen, as we start AWL 287. Into the cover, strange cover, but one, two, no, just didn't have enough leverage, didn't have enough of a hook on that leg. Dragon, no, Taiga suplex, release. European uppercut, kick to the thigh, kick to the stomach. Going to round the world, boom! If there were royalties on wrestling moves, Amazing Red would be a billionaire. Irish whip into the corner. M05's back in control now. And yes, he's thinking about that drive-by drop kick. A signature of the Dore Corps. A victory over Wyvern here would help get M05 out of the doghouse. The man who won and lost the grand championship for the Dore Corps. Wyvern in trouble, springboard. Oh, and he missed! He missed! Wyvern with an opportunity! Can he take advantage? He's looking for a Shinjidai Sunrise! Referee in position this time. Hisatsuwaza! Shinjidai Sunrise! He's got the grip! One, two, three! And that's it! Victory for the Young Dragon over the slaves of Dr. Jigoku.
Here's your winner, Wyvern!
That has to be an emotional victory for the man who escaped the cult to get a pinfall victory over one still remaining in that wicked organization. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Animated Wrestling League. We continue now with tag team action. Two teams, 0 points. Who will make that first step towards championship gold and glory?
The following contest is scheduled for one fall in the tag team division. Introducing first, making over to the ring, accompanied by the Manipulator, the tag team combination of the Serpentine Sensation, Elite Sky and King Akira. Together they are Monster Unions. Currently they have 0 points.
Here cometh the monsters. The hooded, fanged, and poisonous Elite Sky. The large, powerful, beyond mere mortal concepts of life and death, King Akira, and led, as always, from behind by the witch, by the linchpin, by the manipulator. The forces of the Monster Union will not be represented in the Faction Sensei because the Tokyo Athletic Commission does not permit intergender wrestling in this arena. I'm sorry about that, ladies and gentlemen. But that means that Nekomusume and Wild Thing, who are both active in the Joshi division, cannot join Hibitsukai and King Akira to form an Atomicos quartet, which means that the golden opportunity is available to the winners of the faction war, forbidden to the Monstai Union. You can imagine the manipulator not particularly happy about that. This team comes in with 0 points. 3 points necessary, 3 consecutive victories needed to challenge for the world's tag team titles. And here come the young guns.
And their opponents, also with 0 points, the tag team combination of Hiroyuki Shota and Flash Nobuyuki, the Flying Yuki.
Hiroyuki Shota in the orange and green, Flash Nobuyuki, I'll let you guess. Again, 0 points. Looking at the tag team rankings right now, we actually have a correction to make. There was an error in last week's episode. The Dorei Core team of DB02 and H03 actually won their third point last week. They have the right to challenge for the tag team titles. They were accidentally represented as only having 1 point going into last week's episode and winning their second over Gamba's Shadows. They did in fact win their third point. I apologize for the error. We've also got a couple of teams on 2 points. Danger 13, the Spirit Pack, and Eruption Solar and Jushin Thunder Liger. Also a smattering of teams with 1 point. But these two currently with 0, looking to get on the board. Hibitsukai to start us off against the more technically sound of the two Flying Yukis, Hiroyuki Shota. Go behind, waist lock, trying to strangle the snake. That's not a smart idea. You don't go for the body of a snake, you go for the head. Takedown, there you go, go for the head. Control the head and the body will follow. Oh, an elbow tie up into a wrist lock here. Chain wrestling, oh, interesting. A deeper hook of the arm, oh, into the arm drag. And Hibitsukai backing off, backing down, begging off, as they say. That is awesome. You wouldn't think that two young Japanese wrestlers would have much of a hope against literally monsters out of the Universal Library, but turns out they do. If you can chain wrestle a snake, you've got some talent, kid. 1 minute in, it's been fairly even Steven so far. What do we have now? A little bit of control action. Going, oh, trying to go to the Monster Union corner. Hiroyuki Shota not going to allow that. Irish whip into the corner. Boot to the head. Irish whip into the corner, and the tag team strategy so important here. The ability to use your partner, use the five count, use the tag Kogeki. That is vital in an AWL tag team match. And there's the first tag of the contest. Boom! A huge right hand by Flash Nobuyuki. The more, shall we say, sports entertainery of the Flying Yuki team. Snake bite! Snake bite! Snake bite! Out of nowhere! The snake bite of Hibitsukai! And I don't know how Flash Nobuyuki is standing there. Maybe Hibitsukai didn't quite get all of that, but the Yuki gonna fly. No, he's not. He's gonna roll. The rolling Yukis. That might be a good strategic decision at this point of the match, however. As King Akira calls for the tag, the manipulator not happy about this in the corner. And no reversal! Hibitsukai isolated so far by the Flying Yukis. And now into the neutral corner. Clothesline to the back, and it's always the shot. Uh-oh, no, King Akira. Dirt shape. On orders from the manipulator, King Akira serving his mistress well. Irish whip back into the flying Yuki corner. Catch of the Japanese Business Persons Association kick. Into the corner again. We have a tag. No! Ibitsky just cannot make a tag for the freaking life of him. And again, another tag team. Kogeki, what do we have here? A little bit of fine. Finally, the Yukis take to the air. Axe handle smash off of the middle rope does its damage. Up. Oh, what is he thinking? Fall away slam. Or coming from the Snake Man, fall away slam. I'm sorry. And will he finally a tag made by Monster Union and the powerhouse, the largest man in the match by a head and shoulders height. King Akira enters the fray. And that's it, kid. You're not going to be able to control a man the size of King Akira. Knee strike takes Ryuka Shota down. He might have an injury to that quadricep muscle. Going to go for a German. No chance in hell there. Oh, huge splash into the corner with a forearm strike for good measure. And now a knee drop. You're not going to see great technical prowess out of King Akira, but he doesn't need it. And wait, there's the sleeper hold. Having to drag the body. No. Mostly because I'm not entirely sure there's still blood pumping through that carotid artery, which would make the sleeper hold completely ineffective. Oh, and hanging the wrappings out to dry. It's only our second match of the evening, ladies and gentlemen. Good old-fashioned body slam, sit-out style. Okada Kazuchika is in the building. Black Tiger Justice looking to become the first AWL wrestler to hold the IWGP Heavyweight title. That is the main event tonight. We're also going to be starting the Faction War. It's going to be the Technicos. Uh-oh, wait a minute. Technicos Nippon Yokada later tonight. The manipulator in the ring. That is blatantly illegal. King Akira with a sacrifice to the Egyptian gods. This is nuts. Referee, is he going to make the cover? Yes, he is. One. Going to make the count, I should say. Hiroyuki Shota saving the match. As Hibitsky in as well. Snake bite to the illegal man. Snake bite. We're down to one in, one out. Referee gaining control of the contest. Missed with the cross body block. Minutes, 50 seconds on the clock. 15 minute time limit in this tag team affair. Irish whip into the corner. Kick to the head. And a kick to the back of the knee into a cutter. Not exactly a full snake bite, but it worked. And no sign of Flash Nobuyuki following that snake bite from Hibitsky. Uh-oh, here we go. Up, down, the huge scorpion splash and the stinger splash in the corner. Miss with the knee. So far, King Akira has just been outmaneuvering Hiroyuki Shota this entire section of the match, and they've been the legal combatants. And a tag made on one side, diving tag on the other, but did the snake bite take too much out of Flash Nobuyuki? I don't think so. The adrenaline coursing through his veins right now, whereas the venom, of course, in the veins of Hibitsky. Miss with that knee. Knee strikes not working for the flying Yukis right now, but flying clotheslines seem to be. Drop down for the human tag team, the human world versus the monster world. Now we go, oh, German suplex hold a one. As King Akira breaks down the bridge. Oh, wait a minute, the manipulator throwing a steel chair into the ring. I'm not sure if Flash of Yuki noticed it immediately. He sees it now. Irish whip into the corner, tag, no! Yes, he hit it, he hit the Huluva kick. The Japanese Business Association kick, if you insist. And up into a half crab. This match has been back and forth the entire time, ladies and gentlemen. 6 minutes and change remaining. And there's a big old tag. Monster Union. Up, down. Oh, not again. He did it to Hiroyuki Shota. And now, Flash Nobuyuki, a sacrifice to the Egyptian god. The referee's gonna have something to say about this. One, two. Manipulator not allowed in the ring. She's been ejected. She's been red carded. She's gone. Oh, and the referee gets hit. Is he gonna disqualify? I don't think so. I think he's gonna claim incidental contact. But that chair goes away. Thanks, Manipulator. See you later. This also means the Manipulator will not be at ringside for Nekomusume's match, number one contender's match in the Joshi division, a little bit later tonight. And a stand, oh my god! Or oh his gods, a standing moonsault. What is this? Oh, leg breaker! A human leg not intended to move in that direction. Less than 5 minutes remain now. Here we go, Eien no Chopper! Chops forever! Going for one big one. No! Boom! Punch to the face. As I keep saying, it's always the punch you don't see coming that knocks you out. Tiger suplex! Are there tigers in Egypt? I don't even know. One, two, no! Two and a half! As Flash Nobuyuki barely able to get out of this spin kick. Caught, small package driver. Under 4 minutes now. Oh, what is this? Oh, the claw. Choke, claw slam. From the giant of Monster Union. One, two. What is this? A little illegal action here. Only 3 minutes and change on the clock. Missed with that kick. I'm thinking some of the face paint may have gotten into the eyes of Flash Nobuyuki here. Either that or he's got the best sweatproof makeup in the world. Guillotine! Guillotine leg drop. And no, you are not going to be that stupid. Yes, you are, and it almost worked! It almost worked, the dead man dropped to the dead man. If that splash had hit, that could have been the end of the contest. Sling blade. Monster Union being taken to the extreme, taken to their limits. But wait a minute, what is this? Hiroyuki Shota being brought into the ring illegally and painfully with the Davey Boy suplex. Shota wisely rolls out of the ring, but the referee's not going to disqualify if you're being brought into the ring against your own will. That would be ridiculous. 2 minutes. Mark. We have here. Oh! Lariato! What? Does this monster have up his sleeve now? A very simple double wrist lock. As Flash Nobuyuki, Bulldog! Flash Nobuyuki shaking, having to shake feeling back into that arm. Tag made, but back to Hibitsky. Going for the snake bite, no, drop, toe hold. Into the corner, opportunity knocks. Boom! 80 seconds, you only got 80 seconds left, kid. Get in there and pin him. Oh, again, miss with the spin kick. One minute remains. I think Hibitsky actually bleeding now. Irish whip into the corner. The final tag of the match, perhaps. No, collar and elbow tie-up, escape. Vertical suplex. Drops him down with a brain buster. Pin, pin, pin. Don't do that crap. Nobody ever made money doing that. Well, except for one guy that we don't talk about much anymore. I don't think Flash Nobuyuki sees the clock. He's only got 20 seconds left. Make this count, kid. Yakuza kick it in the corner to call it what it really is. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. There's the kick. 1, but it's too late. This match is a time limit draw. Coming up next, Monster Union's Nekomusume versus Dragoness. The winner challenges the champion.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall in the Joshi division, and right is on the line. Introducing first in the winner in from Shima Prefecture, Japan. He is one half of the reigning and irresistibly Joshi Tag Team Champion. And the number one contender in the AWL Best Four, the daughter of the Dragon, Dragoness!
I think the skills of the Dragoness explained me purely by the length of that introduction. We have another member of Monster Union.
And her opponent, making her win the ring, representing Monster Union. She is the number two contender in the AWL Best Four, Nekomusume.
And let's not kid ourselves, the gorgeous Nekomusume making her way into the ring. She was the number one contender until Dragoness defeated the new champion in a non-title match last week. And now Nekomusume has to fight for her right to challenge for the AWL Joshi Championship. Determination and confidence, respectively. 10 minutes on the clock in this one-fall singles match. Double leg takedown by Dragoness, trained from the cradle, trained from the egg, if you will, to be a professional wrestler, tutored by her father, the first woman to go through the AWL dojo system. Nekomusume, recruited from the realm of the yokai by the manipulator to fill out the ranks of the Monster Union. The cat spirit, the cat daughter, the Nekomusume. A Japanese traditional spirit of Japanese yokai given physical form here in the Animated Wrestling League. Dragoness into a Fujiwara armbar. Nekomusume able to roll out of it. What do we have here? Oh! Inverted DDT by the dragon who would be champion. Her tag team partner, her co-holder of the AWL Joshi Tag Team titles, Akira Marine, lost the AWL Joshi Championship. But now, Dragoness looking to pick up the slack for their faction, for their team. And up, down, and another double leg takedown. Dragoness with clearly with the power advantage here and making good use of it, I would say. Snap Hurricane Rana, however, by Nekomusume, whose agility is second to none in anywhere in the AWL, I'd say anywhere in professional wrestling. But Dragoness is going to be power over speed and agility. Power and experience. I will point out, not a lot of positive win-loss records in the Joshi division. However, Dragoness comes into this match record of 23-5, ratio of plus 18. Now wait a minute, going now for Dragon Drop number 3 to Nekomusume, record of 8-5, plus 3 total. Referee slightly out of position, but the 1, 2, and that 1 second of hesitation by the referee, the difference between victory and defeat. Dragoness stalking her prey, thinking for the original Dragon Drop! Dragon Drop! Dragon Drop number 1 into the cover. 1, 2, 3, no, 2.5. Resilience, determination by the cat girl. Oh, wait a minute, pulling on the ears, that's not kosher. You do not pull on the ears of the cat girl. That should be a war crime. Snap vertical suplex by Nekomusume. Enjoying the feeling of control and power. But as a cat, it hers by right over the universe. Huge kick right to the face. Nekomusume going for cat scratch fever. It gets blocked. And an arm breaker. Oh! That's a separated shoulder easily right there. That's a trip to the VET. Dragon is celebrating. The AWL fans on their feet in support. She's going for the Dragon Star, perhaps. Isatsuwaza, Dragon Star, knees. The hind legs. Caught by the toe beans. And somehow her abdomen, her gut, her ribs have got to be on absolute fire right now, ladies and gentlemen. Mostly gentlemen, let's be honest here. But Dragon Drop number 3 connecting. But Dragon has clearly had the wind knocked out of her. Didn't see the knees and she was already in mid-air, unable to change direction. The winner of this contest, remember, will face Jackie Molyneux, the new and second AWL Joshi champion. And that match tentatively scheduled for next week. We await official announcement on awlwrestling.blogspot.com of that bout. Assuming we have a winner in the next 5 minutes and 8 seconds. Going up. A gut-wrench powerbomb, not a move that Dragoness pulls out of the arsenal all that often. We will have the updated best 4 of the Joshi division for you momentarily once this match has concluded. So you will see. Oh, wait a minute! The Dragoness Sleeper! The Dragoness Sleeper, her own variation of the Dragon Sleeper, very nearly ending the contest right there. Kick to the midsection, possible Dragon Drop, no. What do we have here? Back to that arm. Going after the arm, trying to take away the feeling in that arm. You may take away the ability to hit the handspring necessary for the perfect landing. The finishing maneuver of Nekomusume, the perfect landing, take out the arm and that goes away. Less than 4 minutes, what is that? What the, oh my God! What the hell? And now into a Dragon Sleeper of her own. That last maneuver, that neck breaker, that was a, That was a potential kill shot. Good God, Nekomusume, cover. I think we've seen, ladies and gentlemen, that this Monster Union faction willing to go to whatever lengths necessary to win, even beyond the bounds of good taste and sportsmanship, that I know the Dragon family does hold very dear. And the damage done to Dragoness, not able to even pick up the slight and slim tail attack by Nekomusume, not even able to pick up the slight and slim Nekomusume for that a body slam maneuver. 2 minutes and 2.5 minutes approximately into a headlock, chin lock. Dragon is going to have to claw her way out of this. Good, cut it, no, well, up at the top. Double wrist lock, we saw King Akira using that earlier. Possible something that Nekomusume picked up in sparring, who knows. And the seventh time in the match, a double leg takedown. And into, off the ropes for a big stomp. Less than 2 minutes remain now. And going for the catatonic. Catatonic, catatonic. Nekomusume with the catatonic, that's gonna be it. One. Two! Wow, somehow Dragoness, after nearly having her neck broken, able to muster up the energy to get one shoulder off the ground. Note she didn't fully kick out of that, but all it takes is the one shoulder off the canvas. Irish whip, in the corner, Nekomusume playing with the mouse now. Don't think she has time for that. Tail attack. You call it a hip attack, she calls it a tail attack. Deal with it. 65 seconds. Now 1 minute. Whatever you're going to do, Nekomusume, do it now. A flurry of offense. The claws are out. Okay, going for the second time here. Catatonic reversal into an inverted DDT. 35 seconds, Dragoness. If you're going to do this, do it now. 30. Hisatsuwaza. Dragon drop. Dragon drop. Cover. Make the cover. 20 seconds on the clock. 1, 2, 3 to the very last minute, literally. But Dragoness, the number one contender.
Here is your winner.
And there you see, ladies and gentlemen, the updated best four ranking. Dragoness, Nekomusume, Wild Thing, and Athena Jane all waiting in the wings. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is time for a brand new tournament here in the AWL. 8 teams of 4 in a single elimination tournament. The winners all receive golden opportunities. However, if you lose a match in this tournament, you enter the loser's bracket, where all 4 of your careers are in jeopardy. There will be a winner's tournament and a loser's tournament. You want those golden opportunities, but you have to risk your AWL contract to make it happen. First team out, we apologize for the graphical mistakes here.
The following contest is a first round match in AWL Faction Sensor. Introducing first, the quartet of the Technical Wizard Lee Masters, the Suplex Master Sunny Dix, and the reigning Animated Wrestling League Intercontinental Champion, Matt Classic Senior. And okay, one. Where's the fourth guy? What's going on here? Okay, yeah.
Matt Classic Senior, the only active champion in this tournament, ladies and gentlemen. He has made clear to me that if he wins a golden opportunity, he is going to demand a match with Gamba Hishi Dark. And if Gamba Hishi Dark is defeated, the stipulation will be that Matt Classic Jr. gets his job back. Because over a season ago, the Matt Classic Sr.'s son, his career ended by Gamba Hishi Dark. And Gamba's sole mission in the AWL has been vengeance and hopefully justice. However, this is an Atomico's tournament. I only see three guys. Who is going to be the fourth member of the new iteration of the Technicos? Okay, that makes sense.
And the fourth member of the team, making his way to the ring from Yokohama, Japan, the Scion of Suspicion, Shiba Akagi. Together, this team is known as the Technicos.
So we've got a submissions expert, a suplex expert, an MMA fighter, and the guy who invented professional wrestling. This is going to be one hell of a quartet, but they're going to have to face a well-oiled machine.
And their opponents, introducing first, a self-proclaimed your skin is a girl, Domino Jiro, the Japanese Rusher, Paul Saiki, and the Prince of the Pinfall, Ethan Fuji. Wait, we know where their voice guy is, why not look there? Whatever.
Well, apparently, Nippon Yokata found out that one of the Technicos is going to get a special individual entrance. They insisted on it for one of their guys. And process of eliminations, considering the graphic we saw earlier, that's going to be Kyojin Kobayashi. And you see the big man, the guy who is the official leader of this stable, Japanese nationalists. They hate the fact they're going to have to fight Gaiji. They prefer to only face fellow Japanese. Secret weapon of Nippon Yokata, their rookie member.
And the fourth member of the team, Kyoji Kobayashi.
An absolutely enormous human being. He's a rookie, recent graduate of the AWL Dojo. But he brings a power, a size, an intimidation factor that it's hard to underestimate. He doesn't necessarily need to be that great of a wrestler. They've already got enough good wrestlers on this team. They can have an enforcer, they can have a bruiser, they can have someone whose job it is to just scare their opponents and, if necessary, beat somebody into a bloody pulp. All matches in the Faction Sensaw will have a 30-minute time limit. There will be no draws here, ladies and gentlemen. Not if we can avoid it. Starting off, Matt Classic Senior versus Yamba Jiro, the two team captains. Making it clear, Matt Classic press. Classic coming out of the gate strong. The question of this kind of a match is going to be, who's going to use their teammates the best? You've almost inevitably got somebody fresh you can tag in. Who's going to do that? And who's going to be foolish and try to go the distance on their own? And a lot of big egos in this tournament. We don't know what's going to happen here. Win a match, you continue on in this single elimination tournament. lose a match, and you enter the loser's bracket. At AWL 300, the season finale, there will be two Atomicos matches. One to decide the winner of the four golden opportunities, and one to be contested among the losers of the tournament, with all four of their careers ended, fired, released, terminated. Oh God, what is this? Oh! Almost a variation of Starfall. If you remember the Liga Cosmica tag team, that was their shtick. Sammy Nix now in legally alongside Hasaiki. The Japanese Crusher, that's what Hasaiki means, by the way, is Crusher in Japanese, at least according to my dictionary. And, oh, elbow strike, followed by the dropkick, swatted away. Sammy Nix, a suplex expert, not a high flyer. He likes to prove he can, he's more than a one-trick pony, but sometimes the pony needs to stick with the trick, if you know what I'm saying. Irish whip across the hypotenuse of the 20 by 20 foot ring. Tag is made, in comes the Scion of Submission, and what is this? Innovative, and I have to believe improvised, tag team Kogeki, tag team attack, and they pull it off beautifully, and now the submission expert searching for, beautiful takedown, and this gives him all sorts of options for submissions, although with three guys on the outside to break things up, I don't know if submission wrestling is maybe the best plan here. So maybe Chiba Akagi wasn't the best plan here. What do I know? I didn't invent professional wrestling. Matt Classic did. Tag made, in comes the specialist on the Nippon Yokata side, the Prince of the Pinfall, Ifumi Ryuji. In Japanese, an alternate reading of Ichimi-san is Ifumi, and it is actually a real surname. I had a student named Ifumi at one point. And yeah, those were her kanji. 1, 2, 3. And up, down, across the top strand are white, red, and white ropes, of course, the colors of the Japanese flag. And a diving elbow and tag made to the mixed martial arts expert, Lee Masters. Some call him the technical wizard. Some call him the penultimate fighter. Other people call him the guy in blue shorts. All three are accurate summations. And now stomping away at the hand and the fingers, senior official Joey Babaganoush of the Babaganoush Wrestling Family, the famous Babaganoush Wrestling Family, not gonna be happy about that, but maybe his mind is focused on our main event tonight, and that's for the IWGP Heavyweight Championship. Okada in the building, he is warming up backstage as we speak. That match will have a 60-minute time limit as per IWGP rules. Spinebuster! Double leg takedown. Call it whatever you like. It hurts. The sound of the ring echoing throughout this arena. And the tag is made. And we have some tag Kogeki. What do we have here? Oh, yes! We're going for it. The ultimate tag Kogeki. Technical perfection. Perfect. Synchronization! A move that has won them half a dozen tag team titles over the years. 1, 2. Broken up by the giant. You could almost take one step into the... Oh, and there goes the giant. He hangs on to the top rope, however. Yojin Kobayashi removed from the ring. We're down to one-on-one, as it should be. Nearly 5 minutes into this contest. Remember, the winners of this match will advance in a single elimination tournament for a golden opportunity apiece. Death Valley Driver, he rolls through the second death. Into the cover, perfect timing for the pinfall. 1, 2, damn it! Nippon Yokata advances in the faction sensor.
Here are your winners advancing in the faction sensor.
I just said that.
Nippon Yokata, the technico, enter the losers tournament.
That is not good. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a rare event. I believe this has only happened once in AWL history. This will be the second time the IWGP title defended in our ring.
ただいまより本日のメインイベントでございます。IWGP ヘビー級選手権試合60分一本勝負。The following contest is your main event of the evening, scheduled for one fall with a 60-minute time limit for the IWGP Heavyweight Championship of the World.
10年早いんだよ。
They call him a tiger, but at this point I've got to think butterfly is the opportune animal, as in the stomach of BTJ, Black Tiger Justice. He has this once in a lifetime opportunity for a non-New Japan wrestler and someone who's not even technically by New Japan standards a heavyweight to challenge for the IWGP Heavyweight title. And the entire Tiger team is in the ring, ready to back up their youngest member, I believe. Slightly younger than Shin Tiger Jr. And the coin drops. The crowd goes wild. That could only mean, yes, there he is, ladies and gentlemen. The man that many say, myself included, is the greatest professional wrestler in the world today. The leader of chaos. The IWGP Heavyweight Champion, the top title in Japanese wrestling. And he is defending it tonight in the AWL. He has not only a match on January 4th with the gold star, Ibushi Kota, he has a title for title match with the IWGP Intercontinental Champion, whomever that might be, on January 5th, the two most challenging nights of his career. He is gracing the Animated Wrestling League with his presence, the Rainmaker. There you see that beautiful fourth belt of the IWGP Heavyweight Championship. Could that be around the waist of Black Tiger Justice? It would be an upset. It would be the upset of the century. It would be the Black Tiger Shock. But it could happen. And that's what it's all about, the IWGP Heavyweight Championship. Beautiful championship belt, one of the best in the world, I think.
Introducing first the challenger, representing and accompanied by the Unified School of the Tiger Style, one half of the AWL World's Tag Team Champions, Black Tiger Justice! And his opponent, he is the reigning and defending IWGP Heavy Kyoza, the leader of chaos, fighting out of Aichi Prefecture, Japan, the Rainmaker! Okada, Kazuchika! This is an officially sanctioned IWGP Heavyweight Championship match under the auspices of New Japan Pro Wrestling, International Wrestling Grand Prix, presiding at the sound of the bell, AWL senior official Joey Babaganoush in charge.
We would like to thank New Japan Pro Wrestling for not suing our pants off over this. 60 minutes on the clock. 60 分一本勝負. Collar and elbow. The Rainmaker in the corner. Referee gets involved, but he backs off. Oh, wait a minute. No light touch on the chest this time. Does that indicate perhaps that the Rainmaker's maybe a little scared of the Black Tiger? I don't know. Could be, probably not, but could be. This young apprentice of Taiga Zadaku, co-holder of the tag team titles, the men's tag team titles, beat Okada to win that belt. And the Rainmaker with a neck breaker. Followed up by a big knee drop right to the mask. That mask of Black Tiger Justice, that is not going to provide any real protection. So that's, he's going to feel the full impact of that. That's going to hurt. And Okada not getting paid by the hour here. One. I truly believe Black Tiger Justice has the potential to win this match. And that's how he's going to do it, with a big kick. Okada not used to fighting junior heavyweights by New Japan standards. There we go. That's what you've got to do. Hit the high-flying offense. And don't let Okada get up ahead of steam. Don't let him go for that tombstone. Don't, certainly never let him hit the Rainmaker. Uh-oh, opportunity here. Oh, just what I just said. Tombstone! That could be it, ladies and gentlemen. One, two, no! That was just a one count. That was a one count off of the tombstone of Okada. And he's going to the headlock, and this is, I think this is Okada reconsidering his game plan, because Black Tiger Justice just took one of Okada's best shots and kicked out at one. If Black Tiger Justice can hit his double moonsault, if he can hit the Black Tiger Buster, this could be it. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, remember, under New Japan rules, the title can change hands on a count out. 20 count on the outside. Title cannot change hands on disqualification, however. The disqualification is extremely rare under New Japan rules, and the folks over at the International Wrestling Grand Prix have instructed senior official Joey Baba Ganoush of the famous Baba Ganoush Wrestling Family. Wow, double springboard. And I'm pretty sure Black Tiger Justice got all of that. As I said, Joey Baba Ganoush of the famous Baba Ganoush Wrestling Family instructed to swallow his whistle on disqualifications. Oh, wait a minute. The Rainmaker gonna show that he can fly if he has to. Not his usual bailiwick, but Tope Suicida! As Okada makes the dive through the ropes. Yes, this is awesome. This is unbelievable. This is the Animated Wrestling League. Black Tiger Buster, no. Low vertical suplex, low brain bust. Whoa! Okay, Rainmaker pose. Messing with the laws of physics here in the Animated Wrestling League. Also, I'm just really bad at editing and I can't really do a wide shot. Camel clutch locked in. And that spatial distortion apparently doing some damage to the Black Tiger Justice, quite possibly. Kick to the midsection. Wait a minute. He's on Suwaza. Black Tiger Buster. Could it be? Could he do it? Is BTJ going to the Tokyo Dome? One, two, two and a half. Two and a half. Less than a second between completely changing his life. Black Tiger Justice. Okada cannot take him lightly now. Big back body drop. An escape, cat and mouse back into the ring. Perfect drop kick. The picture perfect textbook drop kick of the Rainmaker, Okada Kazuchika. And could that be it? Could that be the knockout blow? Yes, it is. We all thought this was the beginning of the end. But no, look at BTJ, Black Tiger Justice. Not even a one and a half there. Tope Suicida by Okada. You don't see that very often. This, look at that. Oh, I think Okada may have accidentally braced himself, pushing his fall on the ropes. One, two, look at the referee's hand. Very close to the three. And in the end, boom, the best drop kick in wrestling ends it. the Rainmaker, the IWGP Heavyweight Champion, proving himself the best wrestler in the world yet again.
Here is your winner, and still, IWGP Heavyweight Rainmaker, Okada, on the spot.
Thank you again, Okada. My voice is going. Thank you again, Okada. Stay tuned for next week, AWL 288. The Joshi Championship will be on the line. Faction Sensor continues. But for right now, here in Tokyo, Japan, Horede Imarida.